all. Vipara welcomes you all to its continuing webinar. Today's topic is cash and pay, and the speaker is Srimati Rama Pallavi. A brief introduction about Srimati Rama Pallavi. She is working as the OS in the cash and pay department of South Central Railway Chief Cashier's Office in Secunderabad. Srimati Rama Pallavi is a commerce graduate from Usmania University, and she also holds the computer diploma from CMC Hyderabad. Srimati Rama Pallavi joined the accounts department in the year 1999, having served for 21 years in the cash and pay department. She has been appointed in 1995 in the railway commercial department through VCRC, which is the vocational course in railway commercial working, and she belongs to the second batch in the year 1993-95 of VCRC. Srimati Rama Pallavi has played an important role in the implementation of AFRES and IPAS in South Central Railway by coordinating with excellent solutions and requests, by helping it customizing the cash and pay module to suit the working system, and has been instrumental in execution of the MOU of doorstep banking for collection of traffic earnings of our South Central Railway. We are indeed happy to have her share her experiences on the working of cash and pay department, and we hope that all the participants will be benefited by the latest changes which have been introduced in the cash and pay department. Over to Srimati Rama Pallavi.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much for the introduction, sir. Yes, someone has raised their hand. Nishikanta. Anything to be asked, sir? Okay. So, sir has introduced me. Thank you so much, sir. I am here to tell you about cash and pay department. I don't know how many of you people know the difference between cash and pay sections. I most of the people think that cash office and pay office are one and the same, but the working and totally they are different. I think I have to explain that to everyone today, and I will also impart with what knowledge I have about cash and pay. So just before anything, just let me ask you, what is cash office? Can anybody unmute yourself and tell me what is cash office? What happens in cash office? Anybody? So shall I presume that nobody knows about cash office? Someone please tell. I think this has to be an interactive session. I am going on speaking, and I don't know if you people are listening to me or not.
Hello, madam.
Yes.
Hello.
Yes, yes, yes.
See, from cash, what the cash office means, from all the tickets, reservation counter, who are paid this one, they come to the cash office and pay the amount and take this one, slip.
Hey, madam, receipts are, they come to cash office, that is 100% correct. But yes, they are not...
they pay the amount, what is the reservation amount? It gets tallied for them for the day.
Yes, yes, absolutely correct. But how do they remit to cash office? Anybody has got any idea?
Now actually it has been started with SBI now, madam. They come and collect the cash and give the challan will be given to them, and they remit the cash, and the next day from the cash office that the SBI people will come and collect the cash and go to the bank, and it will be remitted.
Okay, madam. So which railway you belong to, madam?
SW Traffic Accounts, Bangalore.
Bangalore, SW Railway. So doorstep doorstep bank,
yeah,
implemented,
yeah.
I think from 2016
started.
They have implemented doorstep, but I think many of the railways, they have not gone on board with doorstep banking yet. I think they are still following the conventional procedure of receiving earnings through cash safes.
Yeah.
Most of the railways. I think few railways have implemented, not all the railways.
Yeah.
So first, let me just start my presentation. So everybody, can you see the screen?
Yeah.
You see the PPT?
Yeah.
Madam, can you mute all the participants, madam, for some time?
Sir, can I do that?
No, yeah, you can also do that, or we can also do it.
Please do that, sir. I think I am unable to.
And the last 15 minutes or 20 minutes, you can ask them to unmute and ask questions.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Please kindly mute everyone, sir.
Okay.
So, first of all, let me introduce you to the three different sections of cash and pay department. So, one is cash, that is cash office. Here we receive all the traffic earnings. Mostly in cash office, we receive only traffic earnings. We do not receive any other, that is any other type of sundry earnings or any other. We only receive traffic earnings in cash office. And these earnings are accounted, tallied, and then hard cash is remitted into the bank. Instruments are also remitted into bank for realization. So this is what happens in cash office. And then we have MCR module. This is the revenue, what is we call sundry earnings. These are all received through revenue counter, which is MCR module. Sundry earnings are mostly miscellaneous earnings like contractual, this EMDs. Yeah, so we receive all the sundry earnings through these MCR modules. Can anybody tell me what are the different types of sundry earnings we receive?
Madam, like electric bill,
okay,
and water,
okay,
advertisement fee.
Sorry?
Advertisement fee.
Yes, yes, advertisement.
And landlining.
Landlining, yes.
Land crab shell.
When you charge. License fee, madam.
Yes, license fees, arrest for EMDs, security deposits.
Bailey's charges.
Yes, yes, Bailey's charges. Yeah, so these are all the sundry earnings which are received through the MCR module. That is this revenue counter in South Central Railway, we have revenue counter in pay office itself. I don't know about other railways. In South Central Railway, revenue counter is maintained in pay office only. And then we have this pay module, which is disbursement of bills and payments. All other various payments are done through pay office. It may be a railway payment or a non-railway payment. Railway payments in the sense our own interest, office interest, some pay orders, something like that. Nowadays, most of the payments are through SIPs and NEFT RTGS. So pay office has got not much role in payment of such bills. Only very few bills are received. Outside payments are like BSNL, LIC, court attachments. So such kind of payments are done through pay office. So these are the three different sections of cash and pay department. Now then, some of the abbreviations I have just put in a slide just for your information. I'm going to share this PPT in the chat box later so that you people can save and have some idea. So these are the people, the staff of cash and pay, who all are working in cash and pay department. So we have Shrofs, traffic cash witnesses, divisional cashier, clerical staff, office assistants. So Shrofs, so what is the role of a Shrof? What he does is he receives cash, he counts the cash. Shrof, the job of the Shrof is only to deal with the cash. And traffic cash witness will witness the counting of the cash. That is, This is traffic cash fitness is posted in cash office to protect the interest of commercial department. That is just to verify if the cash is accounted properly, if it is received properly, if it is remitted properly into the bank. So that is the role of a traffic cash witness. Then we have divisional cashier. He is the overall supervisor of the office. Usually he is the one who remits the cash and, you know, maintains the books and communicates with the accounts department. So he is the overall supervisor of the office. Then we have the clerical staff. Clerical staff, they work in the computer section. They do, most of the time, they do the data entry part. That is, they feed the CR notes, cash remittance notes, which are received from stations. They feed them in IPAS. Now we have IPAS implemented. So they have feed in IPAS. So that is the role of the clerical staff and office assistants. They help in the office work. Now then we have the pay office staff. We have cashiers. So basically these cashiers, they disperse the payments. Earlier there used to be many number of cashiers. These people, they used to go online for payments in different pay districts. If there are any senior people, they might be knowing how a pay clerk is received in stations and how it used to be. I think now all that is cut short. All the payments are online or they are mostly through SIPs now. So these cashiers, they discharge the payments, and we also have a divisional cashier here. He's the overall supervisor of the office. And the clerical staff, these people, they receive the bills. They generate the PMR number. PMR number is nothing but a serial number given to the bills received in pay office. Then these people, they disperse the bills to different cashiers, that is district wise. Then we have the office assistants. So these are the staff available in cash and pay department. So basically why I'm telling you the all these things, because most of the people think cash and pay are one and the same. Cash office and pay office is one and the same. So I'm just trying to tell you the difference between both cash and pay departments. So now let us come to the cash office working. So these are the, I think everybody is able to see the slide.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes. Yes. Okay. So the source of earnings of cash office. So these are all traffic earnings. I think everybody know the difference between traffic and the sundry earning. Yes or no? Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Okay. So first of all, we receive hard cash, that is the currency. Then treasury remittance note. Oh, sorry. This is check. I'm sorry. I'm really sorry. This is check. Okay, so treasury remittance note. What is a treasury remittance note? Can anybody tell me what is a treasury remittance note? Treasury remittance note. It's nothing but our chalan. A chalan is nothing but a treasury remittance note. That is, we are remitting our earnings into the treasury of the bank. That is, cash is remitted through a chalan, which is called treasury remittance note. And similarly, checks are also remitted. This is what we call transfer chalan. A transfer chalan through which DDs and banker checks, they are remitted. Whatever they are received in cash office through CR note, they are remitted into the bank through a treasury remittance note. That is a bank chalan. It is colloquially, we call it as a bank chalan, but it is treasury remittance note. People who are working in IPAS, I think they must be having idea what is a TR note, TR notice. Then we have these e-payments. E-payments are mostly goods earnings. Okay, so whatever freight, demurrage, wharfage, we all receive through e-payment. That is RRs, e-payment RRs. Then we have these swiping machines, point of sale, that is the credit card or debit card, they swipe at the station and they issue tickets. So this is
point of sale.
Then we have UPI. Nowadays, this digital payments have taken momentum. I think we have this Google Pay, Phone Pay, all kind of pays. So that is UPI. So we also receive UPI payments for ticket sales from stations. And then we receive demand drafts and banker checks from stations. So these also we remit into the bank and we obtain the challan. Then we have the, this is the overall working of cash office system. I've tried to put as simple as possible. So I think hope you people are understanding what I'm telling you. So now we, sorry? Yes, someone was saying something. Any doubts? If you have any doubts, you can raise your hand and I think I can hear you. Okay. So now, in cash office, we account, as I told you earlier, we account traffic earnings. That is, sundries are not accounted in cash office. They go to pay office. That is MCR module. Now, how are the earnings received? So, most of the people must be knowing, but then still I'm going to tell you. It is, they are received through traveling cash safes. They are big iron safes. They'll be weighing almost 100 kgs, 1 quintal each. And these safes are designed in such a way that the bags are deposited from the top of the safe and there is a lever which is rotated and the bag is sealed inside. So the one who is depositing the bag or the one who is carrying the safe cannot open the safe or cannot meddle with the bag deposited into the safe. It is sealed at the bottom. Okay, and when the safe, it starts in a safe, I mean, one safe is run in each section. And these safes are run only through passenger trains because passenger trains, they stop in all the stations. That is the reason cash safes are run only in passenger trains. So, these are kept in the custody of the guard. And when the trains arrives at the station, the station staff, they seal the cash, I mean, the day's earnings. Today's earnings is deposited on the next day. Okay, am I clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so today's cash is deposited on the next day. They are sealed in leather bags and they are properly tied and sealed with the leather, I mean the bags in bag seal, and then they are dropped in cash safe. Okay, the guard, he will maintain the summary of all these bags. So he will note the bag number and station name and he will maintain the summary of the particular safe. And this safe, they arrive at the in South Central Railway we have two cash offices, one at Vijayawada, one at Secunderabad. So some safes come to Secunderabad and some go to Vijayawada. So there now in Secunderabad, when the safe is received, this is unloaded by the parcel staff and then the same safe is carried to cash office and handed over to the TCW in charge in the cash office. And every day morning, these safes are opened by the divisional cashier, traffic cash witness, and also RPF. Security staff are also present while opening the safe. They open the safe and they tally the bags which are sent to cash office with the guard summary. The guard will note down the number of the bags and everything in a guard summary, and one copy of the summary is handed over to the parcel clerk, which is also given to the cash office staff. So they tally the cash bags along with the number of the cash bag. The number on inscribed on the cash bag, it has to tally also, because this is to protect the interest of the commercial department. Later they should not say that we have deposited so and so bag, you have not received or we have not received. So these kind of discrepancies are to be avoided. That is the reason the number on the cash bag, the cash bag number is 2, definitely in the guard summary the bag number has to be 2. So that way they are tallied and they are distributed to the sheriffs of the counting hall present in the cash office. So in cash office there will be counting halls with the different cabins, actually counters, actually 1, 2, 3, 4, they are numbered 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and so on. So these bags are distributed section wise to each shroff, and then there in the counter the shroff will open the cash bag. He will count the cash. First of all, he will give the cash remittance note. Their cash is received through cash remittance note. All the entries are summarized in a cash remittance note. It is a 3-foil document. One foil is retained at this. 2 foils are sent to cash office. So the shroff will hand over the CR note, cash remittance note, to the TCW, and he will start counting the cash. So he will count the denominations, and TCW will check the denominations that are available in the CR note, and both have to tally. And the total cash, when it tallies, they put the stamp and they countersign the CR note. Then this bunch, I mean, section-wise CR note bunches are prepared, and these are acknowledgements. As I told you, 2 copies are sent to cash office. That is, 1 copy will be sent to accounts, and 1 copy will be sent back to station as an acknowledgement. That is, the traffic cash witness, he will give the acknowledgement in the acknowledgement foil that suppose station sends 1,000 rupees cash. So the traffic cash witness will say that received 1,000 rupees cash, and he will put the stamp and sign. So that foil he will tear and put in the same leather bag which is received, and the leather bag again is sent to parcel office, and again it is sent to the station. So the station staff will receive the acknowledgement that so and so amount is remitted to cash office. So till now it is clear. Any doubt?
Yes, ma'am.
No?
Yes, ma'am.
So it is clear to you?
Clear, madam.
Okay, okay. So now whatever cash is received, the shroff will make bundles of, that is, full bundles, 100 numbers of bundles of each denomination, and he will hand over all the cash to the divisional cashier. So divisional cashier, he will collect similarly from all the other counters, and at the end of the day, he will prepare a cash chalan and he will remit into the bank. And then what happens to the CR notes which are acknowledged by the TCW? They go to the computer section. Okay, there they are fed into IPAS, and a check sheet is generated for the earnings which are received. Section wise check sheets are generated, and these are again sent back to the counter. So the counter staff, they have, that is, the counter staff, who are the counter staff? Sharoff and TCW. They both have to tally their entries. Sharoff will also make the entry in his Sharoff diary. TCW also will make an entry in his TCW diary. So both the entries have to tally with the check sheet. So what I'm trying to tell you is, this is a foolproof system. If there is any discrepancy anywhere, it will be addressed. Nowhere the cash will not go without tally. So everything will be tallied in a proper way at each place. There may be redundancy in the work, but then whatever earnings are received, pie to pie, they are tallied and accounted in cash office. So now these cash office, CR notes, cash remittance notes, they are, again I told you, one foil of acknowledgement is tore, and it is put in the same leather bag and sent back to the station as acknowledgement. So now while counting the cash, the shroff may receive forged currency or fake notes. Most of the times they detect it. While counting, they will be with their experience, they can come to know if it is a fake note or a real one. So they can immediately, mostly they are all experienced, so they identify a forged note or a fake note, and they send it to RPF. Actually, it is sent to chief cashier's office, and from chief cashier office it will be sent to GRP for further investigation, that note. But then for example, a 500 note is a forged note, the same will be given less acknowledgement in the CR note. So that 500 rupees note cannot be accounted because it is a fake note. Okay, then the station will have to make good the amount later in subsequent CR notes. So that is how forged notes are handled. And then then we have these checks and DDs, EDs and BCs which are received from stations through CRNOs. So these are all, again, separate challans are prepared, and these are also remitted into the bank, and after realization, they are accounted in the cash flow. So in cash office, we have day-to-day accountant. Today's work is completed today only. We don't have any arrears or balance of work carried forward for tomorrow. So whatever cash is received today, it has to be tallied today and it has to be accounted today. If it is a bank holiday, the cash is sealed in a strong room in the presence of chief cashier, divisional cashier, traffic head, traffic cash witness and an IPF. So it is properly sealed in a strong room and remitted on a subsequent working day if there is a bank holiday. Then every day, these at the end of the day, after everything is tallied, that is cash, checks and DDs, everything are tallied, cash book is generated. And this is submitted to bank, book section on daily basis. So now, one important thing comes up. What about the missing earnings? Now the stations might send first and second earnings, third earnings are missing, again fourth earnings are sent. So how are these monitored? Actually, there will be one PCW nominated for this purpose. He will maintain a non-receipt register. That is, he will record the serial number, the CR note number serial wise. If today CR note number 1 is received, tomorrow we have to receive CR note number 2. So the TCW who is nominated for non-receipt, monitoring the non-receipt of the earnings, he checks if the CR note numbers are received continuously or not. If there is a missing CR note, that is, for example, CR note number 4 is missing, he will immediately report the matter to the divisional cashier and head traffic cash witness. And these people, they follow up with the stations. And if the earnings are not received in cash office for a long period, that is for more than 2 or 3 days, the matter will be escalated to assistant chief cashier or chief cashier. And at the level of assistant chief cashier, they monitor with, that is, they speak with the counterparts at the division in commercial department, and they check why these earnings have not been remitted to cash office yet. And they see to it that they are received as quickly as possible. Now we have a concept called cash in transit. So what is cash in transit? Just for the sake of convenience, I am opening a Word document so that I can... So till now it is clear for everyone? You have any doubts? Yes?
No, ma'am, please continue, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Can you see the Word document?
Yes, yes.
Okay, sir. So what is cash in transit? There is a concept. Cash in transit. Has anybody got any idea? What is cash in transit? Cash in transit is nothing but things remitted by stations.
Ma'am, we have not changed the word file.
I have not shared?
No, we cannot see it.
Okay, sorry. Now you can see?
Yes, madam, we can see now.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
So cash in transit is nothing but earnings that are remitted by the stations but not received in cash office. So what does this mean? These earnings are in transit, that is somewhere in the train, somewhere in the safe. So these are not received in cash office. So this is some kind of a danger situation. That is, cash is not yet received in cash office. So what is to be done? This has to be monitored regularly. Why the earnings are not received in cash office? This is the duty of DCW, that is head traffic cash witness, divisional cashier. They have to compulsorily keep track of all the CR notes, and they have to see that these earnings are properly accounted. First of all, find out where these earnings are. Are they in the safe, on in the transit, I mean in the train, or they are lying with the station? This is very important because this is where most frauds happen. What happens is, at the end of every month, till 3rd of, that is, this month is, for example, this is May. So today is May 31st. Till June 3rd, the books are kept open. That is, the month, May month's books are not closed. The accounts are not closed. Till 3rd, we have to receive all the earnings of May month in cash office. So we have to try to account complete earnings as much as possible. We have to just bring the cash in transit to bare minimum. That is, some 1 lakh rupee, 2 lakh rupees like that. Not more than that. We try to do that every month in cash office. Because nowadays the cash payments are less, I mean cash receipts are less. It has not been a problem. But earlier this cash in transit used to be a big concern. Nowadays it is properly monitored and cash in transit is always bare minimum every month. So this is cash in transit. Any doubts in cash in transit concept?
No.
So coming back to our PPT. Yeah. So this is about monitoring the missing earnings and following the stations. Now this is the process flow. What is the exact process at cash office? First, CR note entry is done. Then it is, if there are any problems, it is edited. Then Shroff summary is prepared. Shroff summary is nothing but section-wise cash receipt along with the denomination. The summary of section-wise cash, which has to tally with the denominations of the cash. Then checks, DDs and the POS, everything, the detail entry is made. Then TR note is generated. Treasury remittance note, as I have told you earlier, treasury remittance note separately for cash. And also DDs and VCs, they are generated. And realizations, that is, whatever DDs we have remitted, if they are realized, we receive the advice from the bank. Mostly it will be in 2 or 3 working days. That is, today if we have remitted, we will receive in 2 or 3 days, subsequent 2 days. Then these are also accounted. Actually, in cash book, whatever DDs and VCs are received, they are shown in the closing balance. They are not accounted on the particular day of receipt. They are accounted only when they are realized. That is, when we receive the amount in our railway revenue account, we presume that we receive the amount and we make the realization and it appears in the cash book. And at the end of the day, the cash book is freezed. That is, the day's transactions are closed. So, this is the work process in cash office. So, any doubts in cash module?
Hello, ma'am.
Yeah, please.
Hello.
Tell me. Yeah.
Ma'am, online payments are there. So that has been entered in the cash book. That is the tender money or anywhere online payments which are going on.
Yeah.
What is the effect?
Yeah, online payments, what you are talking, tender money, matlab wo to sundry earnings ho gaya na. That is received in MCR counter, revenue counter, present in pay office. Sir, which railway you belong to, sir?
I am working in CLW, Chitranjan Locomotive Works.
Chitranjan, Adi. So, aapke paas alag sa revenue counter rahega cash office mein?
Alag sa to nahi hai, ek hi counter hai. Actually, hum log ka earnings sa to aisa kuch nahi hai.
हाँ हाँ आपका तो ट्रैफिक कुछ भी नहीं रहेगा आपका तो आपके पास तो पे ऑफिस ही रहेगा तो आपके पास रेवेन्यू काउंटर में ये पूरा रिसीव होगा ऑनलाइन पेमेंट्स भी आएंगे तो वो क्या है ना उसका भी एक्चुअली ऑनलाइन पेमेंट हमको जो एडवाइस आता है एट द एंड ऑफ द मंथ अकाउंट से बुक से आएगा एक एडवाइस आएगा सो एंड सो ऑनलाइन पेमेंट्स महीने का पूरा वो लोग भेजेंगे तो फिर हम लोग वो बैंक में कंफर्म करके फिर उसका एमसीआर जनरेट करेंगे
Okay,
ma'am. In our railway, that is the procedure. I do not know dusre railway mein kaise karte hain. Hamare paas to waisa at the end of the month pure jo NEFT aur RTGS rehte hain na payments, wo pura humko advice bheje jata hai book se
तो हम लोग उसका बैंक पे कंफर्मेशन लेते मतलब एक मैनुअल चलान प्रिपेयर करते हैं उसके लिए हम तो चलान जनरेट नहीं करते थे मैनुअल चलान प्रिपेयर करके वो रियलाइज होने के बाद उसका एमसीआर हम लोग जनरेट करते हैं
तो क्या वो बुक्स में जमा हो रहा है कि आई पास में कैश ऑफिस में?
हाँ हाँ आई पास में जाएगा ना, मैं आ रही हूँ वही पे ऑफिस का पे ऑफिस पे मॉड्यूल और इसमें आएगा एमसीआर मॉड्यूल में, मैं समझा दूंगी आपको वो तो
मेरे यहाँ बुक्स में जमा होने के बाद बुक्स में एंट्री होता है इसलिए मैं।
हाँ हाँ बुक्स में जमा होता है, जरूर जमा होता है वो एवरी डे डे टू डे हो जाएगा डेटा फ्लो डे चले जाएगा।
तो वो अपलोड नहीं करेंगे आई पास में?
आई पास में करेंगे ना, कैश मॉड्यूल में नहीं करेंगे, एमसीआर मॉड्यूल में करेंगे। मैंने शुरू में जो आपको बताया है आप देखिए, ये देखिए एमसीआर मॉड्यूल सेकेंड आइटम आपको जो है यहाँ पे ये वाला मिसलेनियस एंड सन्ड्री अर्निंग्स, तो इसमें आएगा पूरा ऑनलाइन पेमेंट्स जो भी है लाइन या कैश या कुछ भी हो मिसलेनियस और सन्ड्री अर्निंग्स पूरा एमसीआर मॉड्यूल में अकाउंट होगा। एंड ये भी बुक्स को जाएगा, ये डेटा ऑफ द बुक्स को जाएगा,
हार्ड कॉपी तो आएगा लेकिन
हाँ हार्ड कॉपी आएगा, हम एमसीआर काटेंगे वो हम लोग फिर भेजेंगे उनको कॉपी, उनका भी बुक्स का कॉपी भी रहेगा ना वो उनको भेजेंगे कैश के साथ।
और हम लोग कैश से मिला वाउचर से मिला करके कैश देख लेना कि सही है।
हाँ निकल दिखा ओके क्लियर, कैश ऑफिस में तो कोई डाउट नहीं है ना?
क्लियर
क्लियर ओके सर ओके। सो अभी वी विल कम टू पे ऑफिस। सो अभी अभी आप बात कर रहे थे एमसीआर मॉड्यूल के बारे में, देखिए ये एमसीआर मॉड्यूल में तो पूरा सन्ड्री और मिसलेनियस अर्निंग्स जो भी है अभी तक हमने इसके पहले डिस्कस किया था, जो भी लैंड लीज अपना ये जो ईएमडी सिक्योरिटी डिपॉजिट्स ऐसे पूरे इसमें आएंगे सन्ड्री अर्निंग्स में मिसलेनियस अर्निंग्स। अभी हम एम्प्लॉयज भी पे करते हैं ना, सीएल कार्ड लॉस हो गया तो वो 5 रुपए पे करके हम लोग एमसीआर लेते हैं ना। अच्छा ओके सो ओके सो वी पे फॉर लॉस ऑफ सीएल कार्ड, आर यू अवेयर मैडम? इफ वी लूज अवर सीएल कार्ड वी पे 5 रुपीज एंड कलेक्ट एमसीआर।
एक्सक्यूज मी प्लीज, ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट्स आर रिक्वेस्टेड टू म्यूट देयर ऑडियो।
Sir, I think, sir, you have to mute, sir.
No, I am also asking all the persons here. I have muted those who are joining late or...
Achha, okay, sir. Because I am trying to mute, but I am unable to.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, sir. Shall I continue, sir?
Yes, ma'am. Carry on.
Yes, sir. So, Sandhya... we receive an MCR module. And for every receipt, okay. So we give money receipt for each transaction, that is MCR, miscellaneous cash receipt is issued for each transaction, each receipt we have got in pay office. So even here we have different modes of payments, that is cash, DDs and BCs, and also e-payments. Now cash, DDs and BCs are remitted at the end of the day on daily basis. Again the procedure is the same like what we have done in cash office. We generate treasury remittance challans, that is bank challans, and we remit in cash or in bank. Then after realization, these are accounted. So here also in MCR module, we do the day-to-day account. That is, today's transactions are closed today itself. Today's cash is tallied and remitted into the bank. Cash book is generated and it is submitted to books. And end of the transactions, no transactions for that day. Then again, we have the pay module. Pay module is nothing but disbursement of payments. that is from accounts, we receive cash bills or check bills on day-to-day basis. Cashier goes and collects these bills from accounts and brings that to pay office. Then in pay office, PMR number, I think we have seen the abbreviation earlier, Paymaster's registry number. PMR number is nothing but Paymaster's registry number.
उनका उधर कहना मुश्किल है, कब फोन आते हैं जाते हैं खुला हुआ रहेगा वो चैम्बर, पहले वहाँ कोई रहेंगे वहाँ देख लेना, चिट्ठी लगा हुआ है तो यानी कोई नहीं आया,
कोई नहीं
आएगा वहाँ का कोई भी स्टाफ खुल जाएगा,
और
सर आएंगे तो अपना
ये आगे कर made by railway is routed to pay office. Any receipt which is received to railway, it is routed to cash office. That is, ek baat main aapko samjha do, let me make it very clear. Cash and pay, cash office is beginning of an accounting process. Accounting process begins at cash office and ends at pay office. So receipt cash office mein hota hai aur payment ऑफिस में होता
है. क्लियर? थैंक
यू मैम. सो इन पे ऑफिस वी रिसीव द कैश बिल्स, वी जनरेट द पीएमआर नंबर एंड दीज बिल्स आर डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड टू कैशियर्स डिस्ट्रिक्ट वाइज. बिफोर देयर यूज्ड टू बी अ नंबर ऑफ कैशियर्स इन नंबर ऑफ रूट्स, दैट इज ईच कैशियर यूज्ड टू गो ऑनलाइन एंड डू द पेमेंट्स. तो इसीलिए जब एट दैट टाइम बिल्स यूज टू बी डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड टू द कैशियर्स डिस्ट्रिक्ट वाइज फॉर फैसिलिटेटिंग देयर ट्रैवल टू डिस्चार्ज पेमेंट्स इन ए पर्टिकुलर सेक्शन. एक्सक्यूज मी.
पीएमआर मींस क्या हुआ?
पे मास्टर्स रजिस्ट्री नंबर.
थैंक यू.
Paymaster's registry number. So, this number is generated for keeping track of the bills in pay office. If these bills are received, just to keep track of the status of the bill, a PMR number is issued to each bill. It will start from serial number 1 at the beginning of the month. That is, the first bill received on the first day of the month will be bill number 1 and it will be continued at that 1, 2, 3, 4 like that. Then these bills are distributed to the cashiers as I told you, and the cashiers, they do the payments. Okay, and then they also pay, they also disburse the TDs and BCs. TDs and BCs, they may be to railway or non-railway bodies, and these are mostly, they are located by, yeah? Yes, please tell me.
Huh?
Any doubt?
No, green tag, Papa.
No doubts.
Okay, I think I have to, sir. Please mute, sir. Yes, sir. I have muted everyone. Yes. Now, if there are any unpaid bills, that is, validity period of a bill is for 30 days. That is, the bill received from accounts, that is from the date of the receipt, the bill is kept in pay office only for 30 days, not later than that. If the bill exceeds 30 days and it is not paid, it is returned back to accounts as unpaid. So that is at the end of the every month, the paid bills as well as unpaid bills, both are returned to accounts. Paid bills are returned stating the date of the payment and to whom it has been paid, a summary is prepared and it is returned to accounts along with the vouchers also. The bills are also not retained in pay office. The bills are also sent back to accounts. Then after these bills are sent, both paid and unpaid,
acquittance certificate has to be received from accounts. So what is an acquittance certificate? Can anybody tell me what is an acquittance certificate? Anybody has got any idea what is an acquittance certificate? Acquittance certificate.
Summary of bills that not been paid, paid or not paid.
Excuse me,
it is a certificate by the account officer collecting all the paid vouchers.
Acquittance is nothing but accounts office says that you have paid all the bills or you have not paid the bills, whatever. This amount of bills are paid and this amount of bills are unpaid at the end of the month. That is, नहीं समझे आप?
नहीं सर. हाँ.
क्या करना
है? ओके, तो किससे बता दूँ आपको? एक्विटेंस सर्टिफिकेट में महीने का पूरा पेमेंट, जितना बिल्स पेमेंट हुआ है, जितना अमाउंट पे हुआ है, इतना अमाउंट अनपेड है बोल के वो लोग सर्टिफिकेट देते हैं, अकाउंट से पे ऑफिस को देते हैं. ये जो पेड बिल्स पूरा पे ऑफिस भेजते हैं अकाउंट को, तो उसका एक्नॉलेजमेंट समझ लीजिए आप. एक्विटेंस सर्टिफिकेट इज नथिंग बट एक्नॉलेजमेंट ऑफ द पेमेंट्स disbursed by the pay office. This is given by the of the accounts department.
This section, ma'am. This section of accounts.
Ji?
Kaun sa section accounts ka, kaun sa section
hai? Books wale.
Cash and pay section, ma'am. Cash and pay section.
Nahin, cash and pay ko dete hai books wale. Mahine ki?
Ma'am.
Yes, unpaid amount also will be mentioned in the acquittance certificate. Paid amount as well as unpaid amount, both will be appearing in the acquittance certificate. Dono amounts ko hona chahiye. Tabhi liability of the pay office will be discharged. नहीं नहीं एक्विटेंस सर्टिफिकेट तो खाली कैश पेमेंट्स के लिए होगा ना, टिप में नहीं आएगा. इट इज ओनली फॉर कैश पेमेंट.
मैडम
सर, आई हैव टू अनम्यूट देम सर, आई हैव टू म्यूट देम. Yes, sir. I have muted. Okay.
Thanks.
So, certificate. Any doubt in acquittance? Clear?
Clear, ma'am.
Hello, ma'am. It is very important. Acquittance certificate is very important.
Is there a problem?
पे जो भी checking को आते हैं पहले acquittance certificate पूछते हैं.
Hello, ma'am. हेलो मैम, मैम रेलवे में जो है अब कैश पेमेंट जीरो है.
हाँ.
then on what basis people issue accountant certificate? Because the accountant certificate only those vouchers who are going to issue by account office and disbursement by cash office, and after that the those vouchers received from cash office to account office after payment.
Ma'am, after payment of bills, all the paid bills are returned to accounts. They are not retained in pay office. Paid bills will be returned to accounts. Only after return of the complete bills for the particular month. For example, in May, we have received, let us say, some 30 bills in pay office. Okay. After payment, we return all the 30 bills. Only then we receive the acquittance certificate, not before that. Even if it is paid or unpaid, after 30 days, we have to send it back to accounts. Pay office has to send it back to accounts. Only after that, acquittance certificate is issued to pay office. Clear, madam?
But presently, the payment is a cash payment is nil in the LBS then.
Cash payment?
It's nil, zero. Cash payment is nil.
So no acquittance certificate, no payments, no certificate.
Ma'am, hello, ma'am. Yeah. Book section is verifying that the payment has been made correctly and witness is there. That's the manual payment, which was earlier sales that has been occurred, but now it is very small amount or interest, and interest is also payment in through debit card or etc. Cash payment is very small amount.
Sir, I could not understand. Aapka doubt samajh mein nahi aaya.
Madam, is there any particular pro forma, madam, for issuing?
Yes, there is a pro forma. I will share that in the chat box later. There is a particular pro forma. In an acquittance certificate, paid amount as well as unpaid amount and the total amount, it is mentioned. And it has to tally with the pay officer's cash book.
Okay, thank you.
Okay.
Okay.
Next period. Yeah. So, now we had seen the pay office work. Now, we will come to the MCR module. So, in MCR, miscellaneous cash receipt. MCR is nothing but miscellaneous cash receipt. We have three categories. Cash, check and challan. Cash, it is a hard cash received in pay office for which MCR is issued. Again, check. For check, MCR is not issued immediately. First, the check, or that is the DD or BC, whatever is received, it is sent for realization. That is, challan is prepared and remitted into the bank. Only after the check is realized, only after the amount is deposited in railway account, we issue MCR to the party. Then we have this challan. What is a challan? Challan is nothing but the e-payment transactions. Whatever e-payment transactions, that is NEFT RTGS transactions that are received. For this, we prepare a manual challan. We send it to bank. Only after receiving confirmation from the bank that so-and-so payment is received on so-and-so date, we issue miscellaneous cash receipt. Okay? Clear?
Can you please repeat it again, ma'am?
Repeat what? Challan?
Right from miscellaneous cash receipt.
Miscellaneous cash receipt. Miscellaneous cash receipt is issued for the miscellaneous or sundry earnings received in pay office. So they are of three types. One is cash receipt, check receipt, and for online transactions, that is challans. That is, first for cash, hard cash, immediately challan is issued. The miscellaneous cash receipt is issued. For checks, it is not issued immediately. Only after realization of the DD or the BC, we issue miscellaneous cash receipts. And other one, challan. One manual challan is prepared for all the payments received. That is, we receive an advice from the books at the end of every month. And we send it to the bank through a manual challan. Only after confirmation from the bank, we issue miscellaneous cash receipt in favor of accounts. This is issued to accounts. Miscellaneous cash receipt is issued to accounts to facilitate the accounting process. Clear, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
Okay. Then, this is the process flow.
of both check and cash cash MCR. First entry is made, the PR note is generated, then at the end of the day, cash book is raised. Even the same process in the check, but otherwise we have to... Yes. I have muted everyone. If you have any doubts, you can just raise your hand and unmute yourself and ask. Okay. So? So this is the process flow of cash and check. When here, even in case of DDs and BCs received, we do the miscellaneous receipt entry. Then the DR note is generated, and after the DR note is generated, I mean after the realization is done, that is the DDs and BCs are deposited into our railway revenue account, we generate the MR. MR is nothing but the money receipt, and then the cash book is freezed. So this is the process flow of MCR module. Now let us go to pay module. Now here, first paymaster's registry number is issued. Then the bills are distributed to the cashiers. Then here, abstract is prepared. This is what I told you. The paid bills are returned to accounts through a P4, a form called P4. In this P4, the bill number, PMR number, date of payment of the bill, amount of the bill, these are all mentioned, and they are returned to accounts. After that, yes, here you can see the process flow with the cashier. Earlier what I have shown you, it is with the pay clerk. Now this is the process flow of cashier. So PMR, now the cashier here, he will dispatch the checks, he does the cash payments, and he will do the voucher, I mean he will return the unpaid bills and paid bills to accounts. Then he will also maintain the list of checks received in his counter, that is in his district, what all checks he has received, he will maintain the list of the checks, and he will also obtain acquittance certificate from accounts. So this is the process flow of the cashier. Now the biggest question here is, what happens to the data? What happens to the data at cash office? The cash data, first of all, the traffic data, that is the CRN data, it goes to the credit side of the balance sheet.
You told that acquittance certificate will not be issued on the basis of checks, only cash transaction.
Yes, only for cash payments. Yes.
But now just it is displaying the checks, checks of details of checks or list of checks. It will issue acquittance certificate then. What is the correctness?
Correct. Very, very good question. In case of checks, what happens is, the checks will be sent through, if it is a nearby office, for example, a BSNL or LIC, if it is nearby, it will be personally handed over and acknowledgement is obtained. Okay. If it is an outstation check, it will be sent through post. So pay office cannot keep the track of all these the realization of these payment checks, because we do not have the revenue account in pay office. We do not maintain the revenue account at pay office. It is maintained at books only. We only act like a post office. That is, we only dispatch the checks whatever we receive. Yes, for cash we have the liability because we are handling the cash. But checks we do not handle, we do not maintain the revenue account. It is maintained at book section. We cannot keep track of the if the party has encashed the check. But yes, if their checks are returned in pay office, we send it to accounts. If we send it to speed post or to registered post to the party, and if the party do not accept that, it is returned back to pay office. So what we do is, we return the same check to accounts department saying that this check, the following checks are all returned. That's all.
Okay, madam?
See, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Okay.
Clear, madam? Your doubt is clear?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, okay. So now the data flow. What happens to the data? The CR note data will be the credit side data from the balance sheet. The debit side is received from station. Debit is received from station. Credit is from the cash office. Now what happens to the remittance data? That is the challans, TR note details, whatever we feed, it will go to the debit side for RIB reconciliation. Whatever challans we receive in cash office or we generate in cash office, it will become the debit side data for RIB reconciliation. Similarly, MCR data also, it goes for the debit side of the RIB reconciliation. So this is the data flow of cash and pay. So this is about cash and pay module. So can you unmute yourself and ask if you have any questions?
Ma'am, RIB full form?
Remittance into bank.
Yes, yes.
Remittance into bank. RIB is nothing but remittance into bank.
So madam.
Yes, sir.
Almost pay office and cash office are closed.
Yes, so, sir.
How much percentage of cash and pay office is working in Indian Railway?
Sorry?
Kitna percent cash office and pay office Railway mein kaam kar raha hai?
Kitna percent?
All transactions in cash office are almost closed.
Yes. Cash office is not yet closed, sir. Abhi bhi hai. Paper, abhi cash to kam ho gaya hai, lekin paper work to bahut sara hai.
Lekin staff bahut sare accounts pe transfer ho gaye na, madam.
Kahan hua hai, sir? Hamare paas to nahi hua hai. Hum log to abhi cash and pay mein
hi hai. Central Railway mein to ho gaya hai.
I think most of the railways ho gaya hai, lekin इसीलिए तो आपके पास पूरा सरेंडर हो गया है, लेकिन हमारे पास अभी इम्प्लीमेंट नहीं हुआ है. हमने खाली डोर स्टेप बैंकिंग का एमओयू साइन किया है. अभी तो गाड़ी नहीं चल रहे है, इसीलिए होल्ड में है. लॉकडाउन है करके इसीलिए अभी होल्ड में.
मैडम, सीआर नोट क्या है? इसमें थोड़ा बता
दीजिए. कैश रेमिटेंस नोट. कैश रेमिटेंस नोट. सीआर नोट इज कैश रेमिटेंस नोट. सर, ये पूरे अब्रिवेशन आपको पीपीटी में मैंने दिया है. पीपीटी है, आप थोड़ा उसमें देखिए.
सीआर नोट है क्या?
कैश रेमिटेंस नोट.
उससे क्या होता है मैडम, ये पूछना चाह रहे हैं.
कैश रेमिटेंस नोट कुछ भी नहीं है, उसमें पूरा आपका अर्निंग्स आते हैं. आपको स्टेशन वाला बनाता है कैश रेमिटेंस नोट.
मैडम, जो
कैश रेमिटेंस नोट प्रिपेयर करके कैश ऑफिस पे
मास्टर प्रिपेयर.
हां,
स्टेशन मास्टर प्रिपेयर करता है.
हां, स्टेशन मास्टर या बुकिंग सुपरवाइजर जो भी है वो प्रिपेयर करता है और कैश ऑफिस को भेजता है कैश के साथ.
मैम,
एक्विटेंस सर्टिफिकेट के बारे में क्लियर कीजिए. कौन बनाते हैं ये? अकाउंट्स वाले पे ऑफिस को देते हैं. अकाउंट्स डिपार्टमेंट पे ऑफिस को इश्यू करता है ये करके कि पूरा बिल्स आपने पे कर दिया है. जो भी बिल्स अकाउंट्स ने भेजा है पे ऑफिस में, उसका पूरा पेमेंट हो गया है, इतना पेमेंट हुआ है, इतना पेमेंट नहीं हुआ है करके मेंशन करके पे ऑफिस का लायबिलिटी डिस्चार्ज करने के लिए एक्विटेंस सर्टिफिकेट देते हैं.
मैम, ये मैं बता रहा हूँ, जैसे मान लो कोई चेक छपा कैश ऑफिस को हमने जमा कर दिया, तो ये कैसे पता चलेगा अकाउंट्स को कि मैंने क्लियर हुआ है कि नहीं? जब तक वो हमको इन्फॉर्म नहीं करते हैं तब तक पता नहीं चलेगा क्लियर हुआ.
कौन सा बोल रहे हो? पेमेंट
जी, उसके बाद एक्विटेंस जारी. हाँ, बाद एक्विटेंस जारी होगा ना?
हाँ, पेमेंट होने के बाद. अभी पे ऑफिस से बिल्स अकाउंट्स को जाएगा तभी अकाउंट्स एक्विटेंस इश्यू करेंगे ना.
जी,
पूरा बिल्स जो भी अकाउंट्स से पे ऑफिस को आता है, पे ऑफिस वाला पूरा पेमेंट कंप्लीट करने के बाद ही पूरा पेड बिल्स रिटर्न करते हैं अकाउंट्स को.
उसी में वो मैंने वो जिक्र करते हैं कि ये बिल मैंने
उसमें करते हैं ना, उसमें एक P4 करके एक फॉर्म बनाते हैं, उसमें लिखते हैं पेमेंट कब हुआ है, वो पूरा लिख के वो अकाउंट को भेजते हैं,
तो उसके आधार पर
रिस्पांस वाले दे विल गिव एक्सीडेंट सर्टिफिकेट। पेमेंट होने के बाद ही एक्सीडेंट सर्टिफिकेट जारी होगा।
वो कैश ऑफिस को देते हैं या हेडक्वार्टर को देते हैं?
कैश ऑफिस को ही देते हैं, कैश ऑफिस को ही होना है ना, उनका डिस्चार्ज लायबिलिटी डिस्चार्ज करने का है ना पे ऑफिस का।
लेकिन तो पहुंच जाएगा तो देख रहे हैं हेडक्वार्टर को भेजा जा रहा है।
नहीं नहीं नहीं, हमारे यहाँ तो पे ऑफिस में ही आता है, वो तो गलत है। अभी तो नहीं है, लेकिन कैश पेमेंट अगर एक बिल भी है उसको एक्विडेंस सर्टिफिकेट देना चाहिए। एक बिल भी हो, इवन इफ इट इज वन बिल, एक्विडेंस सर्टिफिकेट हैज टू बी इश्यू। That is the main intention of issuing acquittance certificate is discharging the liability of pay office.
Main including SIPs ya chhod ke SIPs ke saath jod ke acquittance
nahi nahi SIPs usme nahi aayega, acquittance certificate mein only cash aayega,
only cash aayega ya SIPs
nahi aayega
ji। Ma'am
yes
मैडम, कैश इन ट्रांजिट के बारे में बताइए ना।
हाँ,
हिंदी में
बताऊं?
जी जी,
हिंदी में बताऊंगी। कैश इन ट्रांजिट कुछ भी नहीं है भैया, कैश इन ट्रांजिट जो भी है स्टेशन से भेज दिया है लेकिन कैश ऑफिस में पहुंचा नहीं अभी तक, दैट इज कॉल्ड कैश इन ट्रांजिट। वो कैश इन ट्रांजिट जितना कम हुआ उतना अच्छा है, ज्यादा नहीं रहना चाहिए कैश इन ट्रांजिट।
अच्छा मैम, एक बात,
वो जो ट्रेन के चलते मैडम जमा नहीं हुआ, सभी कैश इन ट्रांजिट के रूप में है, जब वो जमा हो जाएगा तो
भी जो भी कैश ऑफिस में जमा नहीं हुआ ट्रेन में चल रहा है वो तो कैश इन ट्रांजिट ही होगा।
अच्छा मैम, अभी कैश पेमेंट जहाँ नहीं है, जहाँ अभी सप्लीमेंट्री पेमेंट भी नहीं हो रहा जैसा RTGS और NEFT हो रहा है, तो उसका रिफ्लेक्शन कैश एंड पेमेंट कहाँ है?
कौन सा? RTGS एंड
RTGS और NEFT में जो स्टाफ का पेमेंट हो रहा है, जो भी हो रहा है, कोई सप्लीमेंट्री पेमेंट अभी नहीं हो रहा है।
क्या होगा सर उसका ना, महीने के लास्ट वर्किंग डे के दिन बुक से पे ऑफिस को एडवाइस आता है।
अच्छा,
बुक्स वाले भेजते हैं इतने सारे NEFT पेमेंट्स हुआ है ये महीने में, तो आप पे ऑफिस में आप कंफर्म कर लीजिए, बैंक में कंफर्म करना है पे ऑफिस वालों को, और उसका MTR कार्ड के बुक्स को भेजना है।
मैडम, जो IRCTC के थ्रू अर्निंग होती है ट्रैफिक, उसका क्या होता है मैडम आगे?
वो कैश एंड पे में नहीं आता है, बिल्कुल ट्रैफिक में ही नहीं आता है। इवन द ट्रैफिक अकाउंट्स डज नॉट डील विद IRCTC कैश एनीवे।
तो रेलवे की अर्निंग में आता है मैडम?
हाँ आता है, लेकिन वो डायरेक्ट उसमें जाएगा, ट्रैफिक में नहीं आएगा।
थैंक यू।
अभी सरप्राइज कैशियर वेरिफिकेशन
जी,
सरप्राइज कैशियर वेरिफिकेशन जो होता है मंथली, हो रहा है कि नहीं?
हो रहा है, हर कोई पे ऑफिस में हर एक महीने को एक अकाउंट्स ऑफिसर को नॉमिनेट किया जाता है, वो तो HOD नॉमिनेट करते हैं और वहाँ के सर्विस चेक करते हैं एवरी मंथ।
अब तो वहाँ पे कैश रहता नहीं है, कैश तो रहता नहीं है,
मैनुअल में प्रिस्क्राइब किया हुआ है सर्विस चेक करना है करके।
मैडम, डोर स्टेप बैंकिंग क्या है मैडम?
डोर स्टेप बैंकिंग इज कलेक्शन ऑफ ट्रैफिक अर्निंग्स बाय बैंक। अभी तो कैश से मूवमेंट से अर्निंग्स कलेक्ट हो रहा है, दैट इज स्टेशन वाला पूरा बैग में लेदर बैग में अर्निंग्स फील करके कैश सिप में ड्रॉप करता है, लेकिन अभी डोर स्टेप बैंकिंग के बाद काम देगा, बैंक वाला स्टेशन को जाएगा, जाके अर्निंग्स कलेक्ट करके बैंक में डिपॉजिट करके चालान ला के स्टेशन पे दे देगा। अभी स्टेशन वाले को खाली चालान भेजने का है कैश ऑफिस। पूरा कैश डिपॉजिट करना वो झंझट नहीं, ओनली चालान विल बी सेंड टू कैश इन केस ऑफ डोंट स्टेप बैक.
मैडम मैडम प्लीज एक्सप्लेन इन डिटेल ऑफ सरप्राइज चेक ऑफ कैश ऑफिस बाय द अकाउंट.
सरप्राइज चेक महीने में एक बार होता है सर, वो एवरी मंथ वन अकाउंट्स ऑफिसर इज नॉमिनेटेड बाय एचओडी एंड वो आके सरप्राइज एक दिन चुनके वो आके सरप्राइज चेक करेंगे. क्या क्या चेक करेंगे? ऑन हैंड कैश, ऑन हैंड इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स एंड रियलाइजेशन ऑफ द इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स. जो भी कैश ऑन हैंड है इट हैज टू टैली और इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स भी टैली होना चाहिए. ज्यादा ज्यादा दिन अपने पास पेंडिंग नहीं रखना चाहिए. वो पूरा चेक करेंगे अकाउंट स्टाफ चेक करके, अकाउंट ऑफिसर चेक करके एक सरप्राइज चेक रिपोर्ट बनाएंगे. वो ये भी देखेंगे कि पूरे रिकॉर्ड्स प्रॉपरली मेंटेन हो रहा है कि नहीं पे ऑफिस में और कैश ऑफिस में, उसका भी वो रिपोर्ट करेंगे. वो पूरा रिपोर्ट बना के फिर कैश ऑफिस को एक कॉपी, बुक्स में एक कॉपी, दो जगह कॉपी भेज के एवरी मंथ ये सरप्राइज चेक का पोजीशन पीएफए को पुटअप किया जाए. हमारे पास तो वैसा होगा.
Cash officer staff, then what action has been taken by the account officer?
That will be reported in the report. May record kiya jayega sir. This report will go to till PFA. Okay. HOD ke through PFA tak jayega and action will be taken if there is any discrepancy.
Unpaid wages.
Unpaid wages. सर अनपेड वेजेस का अभी गुंजाइश नहीं है, कैश पेमेंट्स नहीं है सर. इट विल ऑल गो थ्रू सिप्स. सिप्स में जा रहा है पूरा पेमेंट.
स्क्रैप सेल जो बिकता है मैडम,
अनपेड की जगह अभी सीआईपीएस न्यू मॉडल इंट्रोड्यूस हो गया है. अनपेड बिल्कुल खत्म हो गया. तो सीआईपीएस में जो भी आता है अनपेड, ऑल अनपेड विल बी क्लियर थ्रू सीआईपीएस.
Ma'am, is model actually PDF is available? PDF?
PDF
file.
That's study material.
He wants to say something like PPT.
Ma'am? Achha, PPT is already shared in the chat box. PPT is shared in the chat box.
The PPT model is PDF
चाहिए आपको?
हाँ
मैं भेज
दूँगी.
मैं अगर शोरा सर को भेजूँगी आप देख लेना.
ओके
मैम. थैंक यू. संगत
मैडम,
व्हाट इज मेंट
बाय
टिप्स? टिप्स तो मुझे गूगल करना पड़ेगा सर.
CIPS.
सेंट्रलाइज्ड इंटीग्रेटेड
Centralized integrated payment system. Okay, I think cash and pay का पूरा doubt clear हो गया है क्या?
पेमेंट हो रहा है, रिसीव किया जा रहा है मैडम।
हेलो,
ऑक्शन के थ्रू जो पेमेंट रिसीव कर रहे हैं या जो रिफंड कर रहे हैं उसको कैश इन पे में ट्रांजैक्शन कैसे होता है?
सर अभी तो पूरा IRPS में जा रहा है ऑक्शन, पहले तो हमारे पास आता था, हम लोग कंफर्म करके उसका MCR काटते थे, जो भी ये ऑक्शन सेल्स स्क्रैप सेल्स पूरा
वो तो अलग से EMD के तहत ही 2071-68-0 कुछ में आ गया है, अलग से EMD का कैश ऑफिस नहीं जा रहा है,
लेटर बनाना है।
अभी तो नहीं आ रहा है कैश ऑफिस में, पूरा IRPS में जा रहा है।
जी
स्क्रैप सेल्स अभी कैश ऑफिस में नो लॉन्गर वी आर रिसीव करेंगे स्क्रैप सेल्स और ऑक्शन सेल्स इन
कैश।
Okay. So thank you sir, thank you very much. I thank Sitara. So I thank you sir, thank you Nageshwara sir, thank you Sundar sir for giving me this opportunity. So I'm closing this sir, closing. Shall I close the session sir?
Thank you madam, thank you very much.
Thank you sir, thank you very much.
Thank you madam.
The topic is completion reports. Speaker is self. All are requested to log in at 11 o'clock. Session will start at 11:30 hours. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. And thank you, madam.
Thank you, madam.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you all.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
पापा से ना दे दे मिश्रा जी को दे देना हो मिश्रा जी नहीं है जो अंग्रेज साहब को बगल में बैठते हैं वो मीटिंग के लिए है। हाँ हेलो हेलो डायरेक्ट देते डायरेक्ट तुम नहीं लेगा तुमने कहा यही दे दूँगा अपने भी बिल है अंदर में देते
Thank you.